In this video, we are going to go through the producer-consumer problem. So in the producer-consumer problem, we have three variables. We have a buffer, which can hold up to n objects. So in this case, n is equal to 4. We also have variables p for the next index to insert an object. And last, we have C, which also starts at 0. So this is the next index to take out an object. Those are the only variables that we are worried about today. So we have a total of 4 objects, which we may end up using at any given point in time, and we have made them all 4 different colors so that they are easier to tell apart. In this problem, the producer is going to start putting in an object at 0. When it does that, the number of the object to put in next updates so that it is now 1. Let's say that the consumer comes along and takes that object. Now the consumer will also update so that it is now 1. And what this means is that the producer's next place in the buffer to put an object in is at 1. And now the consumer has taken the object that was at 0. It also updates so that the consumer updates so that the next object that it will remove is also 1. One conclusion that we can make here is that if P and C are equal, then the buffer itself is empty and there is nothing there for the consumer to be able to take. So the consumer should only be able to take if the buffer is not empty. The producer will go ahead and put the next object into index 1. So when the producer puts an object into index 1, they are no longer in index 1, but instead in index 2. When the producer puts something in index 2, they are no longer in index 2. They are instead in index 3. When the producer puts something in index 3, they are no longer in index 3. They are in index 0. And when the producer puts something into index 0, they are back to being in index 1. The producer can no longer put anything into this particular buffer because it is full. So we can tell when the producer cannot put anything into the buffer because it is full, because once again, P is equal to C. But wait a minute. If we can tell that the buffer is empty when P is equal to C, and we can tell that the buffer is full if P equals C, well, wait a minute, now we can't tell if we are full or we're empty, and the entire algorithm stops working because neither of our producer nor our consumer can actually do anything. So we need a different definition for full. The one that we have here is not going to work. All right, so let's try, since we know that the producer right now cannot actually do anything, we're going to take something out. The consumer is going to remove object 1 and increase C so that it is now object 2 that it would be removing next. In this case, if we assume that we are still full, we can do some math here to allow us to differentiate between full and empty. So in this case, P is equal to 1, C is equal to 2, and in this case, the producer is one behind the consumer. So maybe we can say that the producer plus one might actually be equal to C, and we consider that to be our definition for full. So if the consumer takes out an object, it takes out the object at 2, and then we set C to be 3, because that's the next object that it would end up taking out. The producer will go ahead and put in an object that will raise its value to 2. So now when the consumer takes out object 3, we're using modulo arithmetic. So the next object that C would be able to, that the consumer would be able to take out, is object 0. So the producer can put an object in at 2, which results in the next object it is able to put in is 3. But according to our definition, we're saying that P plus 1 is equal to C when it's full. So here's the question, is 3 plus 1 equal to 0? And in this case, the answer is yes, but only if we are still using modulo arithmetic. So here we're saying that P plus 1 modulo 4 is equal to C, and therefore our buffer is still full, and the producer is not allowed to produce another object yet. So because this definition of full works, we are able to make a solution here for the producer-consumer problem that has an algorithm wherein we are taking objects out so long as we have objects to take out and the buffer is not empty. And we are able to put objects in as the producer so long as the buffer has less than n minus 1 objects in it.